kann man, hat man heuerisch, ich lehne mein Chor, nimm heuerisch schon, nimm Chor baunayu. Alright, so this is our last video. This will be our conclusion. We're going to be just quickly going over what we have already went over in our previous videos. So let's go ahead and start off with practicing with what we know. And I will translate these two sentences here, but I won't translate this one. And for all three of these, I would like for you to recognize what is the subject of the sentence and what is the object of the sentence, and what particular stem or form it's in. So is it a H stem, is it a I stem, or a stem? And that would include the adjective of the object of the sentence, if there is an adjective. So starting off with this first sentence here, we have tashit na yeta gadun. Tashit na yeta gadun. And for the second sentence, we have lanaya na bonyo bua. Lanaya na bonyo bua. So lanyet is the past tense for listen, so that would be to have heard. So lanyet, to have heard something or to have listened to something. And lanayan is the like listening or hearing something. So this would be lanayan na bonyo bua. I am listening to two red-tailed hawks. Lanayan na bonyo bua. I'm listening to two red-tailed hawks. Khatat na galjina khatashi. Khatat na galjina khatashi. So khatit is our word for to have eaten something, so to like ate. And galjin is our word, the subject form of the word for many or lots of. So galjina is the object form of that. So that is galjina, and that is an A stem. So galjin, subject form, galjina, object form. And khatash is the subject form for food. So khatash is going to turn into the object of this sentence. So it is an I stem, and that changes into khatashi. Khatashi. Khatatna galjina khatashi. I ate lots of food. So going over our H stems. Khatatna takhatiin. Khatatna takhatiin. And this translates to I ate sour berries. Khatatna takhatiin. And we know that takhati is an H stem because it has that vowel at the end. So to turn it into its object form, we're adding that same vowel and then followed by an N. Takhati, takhatiin. Lanyet na shopina kayun. Lanyet na shopina kayun. I heard three coyotes. And as I had mentioned earlier, so whatever adjective or whatever is describing the object of the sentence, that describer or that adjective is also going to get its object form. And this is great because it just harmonizes and makes it really distinguishable of what words or what little taggings are going with that object of the sentence or the subject of the sentence. So, lanyet na, I heard, shopina kayun, three coyotes. Now, if we want to switch that around and we want to say three coyotes heard me, we would say lanyet nan, shopin kayu. Lanyet nan, shopin kayu. Three coyotes heard me. But here I have it the other way. Lanyet na shopina kayun. I heard three coyotes. Taashan jojonaan ma. Taashan jojonaan ma. You are looking at crickets. Taashan jojonaan ma. You are looking at crickets. And for our A stems, ma wushla tashit. Ma wushla tashit. You saw an eagle. You ma tashit saw wushla, an eagle. Now, if we want to change that around, we would say the eagle saw you. It would change from ma to mam, wushla to wushl, and tashit would stay the same. So, ma wushla tashit, you saw the eagle. Mam wushla tashit, the eagle saw you. Ta'ash an bu'a, ta'ash an bu'a. And that means that he, she, or it is looking at red-tailed hawk. And we know this because that word for he, she, or it, ama, the subject form, and the object form of he, she, or it, is missing. So if you wanted to throw that word back in, it would just mean, or it would just say, ama ta'ash an bu'a. Ama ta'ash an bu'a. It is looking at a red-tailed hawk. And the he, she, or it, the word for that, is only the one word that you can leave out of the sentence and still distinguish and recognize what it means. And right under that, we have shidgila lanyatna. Shidgila lanyatna. And shidgila is the object form of shidgil. And shidgil is our subject form for squirrel. So shidgil, subject form for squirrel. Shidgila, object form for squirrel. Shidgila lanyatna. I heard the squirrel. And the squirrel heard me. Shidgil lanyatnan. Shidgil lanyatnan. So for I stems, starting off with lanayan ma chakhlali. Lanayan ma chakhlali. And that translates to, you are listening to the crow. You are listening to the crow. Lanayan ma chakhlali. So chakhlal is our word, or the subject form for the word for crow. And it is an I stem, so the object form turns into chakhlali. Chakhlal, subject form for crow. Chakhlali, object form for crow. Lanayan ma chakhlali. You are listening to the crow. Ta'ash anna k'enichi yitshinla. Ta'ash anna k'enichi yitshinla. I am looking at 5 ants. Ta'ash anna k'enichi yitshinla. So if we want to say that 5 ants are looking at me, we will say ta'ash annan k'enich yitshinil. Ta'ash annan k'enich yitshinil. 5 ants are looking at me. But I have here, ta'ash anna k'enichi yitshinla. Ta'ash anna k'enichi yitshinla. I am looking at 5 ants. And our third sentence here, we have kosoi tashit. Kosoi tashit. So, kosoi is the subject form of mouse, and kosoi is the object form of mouse. And you'll notice that we are missing that particular word, and that would mean that it, he, or she saw mouse. So, kosoi tashit. He saw mouse. Kosoi tashit. It saw mouse. Kosoi tashit. She saw mouse. All right, so now we're going to make up sentences for these two images. First, we're going to say that coyote saw butterfly. So we will say, kayu tashit walapsu'un. Kayu tashit walapsu'un. And if we just want to change that around and we want to say that butterfly saw coyote, we will say, kayu'un tashit walapsu. Kayu'un tashit walapsu. And here we have checha, and here is huya. And we're going to say first that the dog saw the caterpillar. We will say checha tashit huya'an. Checha tashit huya'an. And if we want to say that caterpillar saw dog, we will say checha'an tashit huya. Checha'an tashit huya. And lastly, we have here, we have siksika. And this here is our woodpecker. And the word for this little guy is palatat. And palatat, that is an I stem. So it will change from palatat to palatati. Palatat, subject form. Palatati, object form of woodpecker. So we're going to say that the siksika, the stink bug, saw woodpecker. So that will say, that will mean siksika tashit palatati. Siksika tashit palatati. And we, if we want to say that woodpecker saw the stink bug, we will say siksika antashit palatat. Siksika antashit palatat. All right. And that concludes our last slide for this video. I just want to thank all of you for taking the time and effort to watch these videos. It is much appreciated because it's a very personal thing for me. I always hope that our language will be preserved, especially by our tribal youth and our all of our tribal members, because it's important that we know our language and keep it alive. So I'm very thankful for you taking the time to watch these videos, and I really hope that they're helpful to you and that you've gained something from these videos. Once again, I thank my elders for all the knowledge that they have given me. I don't take everything that they have taught me lightly. It is one of the most important things in my life is the knowledge that they've given me. So I recognize them and all the things that they have gone through and all the knowledge that they've passed down to all of us. And lastly, I would like to thank Clay Dalton for funding these videos. It is much appreciated. I'm very happy that people will have access to our language, especially for like tribal members that don't live in our area. And, you know, meeting up face to face, especially during this pandemic, is hard to learn the language. So very thankful that these videos are online, so they're virtual, so that tribal members and people can still learn the language, even being away from home or from their elders and loved ones that might know the language and they aren't able to meet up with them. So once again, thank you so much. And in Chukchansi, we don't have a word for goodbye. But if you're leaving, you would say "tani na," and that means I'm going or I'm going to go. "Tani na." And the person staying might say "ahuhu." Okay, then "huhu." Or "huhu hia," and "hia" is I like to say that it kind of means like okay, see you later. So "tane na" and "hia."